Brought to you by Eaton Detroit Spring, proudly made in the USA.
Classic Car or Muscle Car, we want to show you how to restore your automobile and save yourself some money in the process. Sometimes we consult the pros, sometimes we mess up. But just remember, it's never a problem, it's always a project.
Right now on Auto Restomod, Jeff tackles heat, plays with fire, and makes posh plastics to spiff up your truck or classic car.
Honey, what are you doing out there?
Waiting on the next Super Blowout 3-Day Only Mega Sale.
You don't need a sale. You need NPD.
NPD's everyday prices are competitive with most sales, and orders arrive fast from our four strategically located superstores. National Parts Depot has quality parts for Mustang, Camaro, Chevelle, GTO, Firebird, Ford, and Chevy truck. For your free catalog, go online or call toll-free.
Working beats waiting.
Right, another happy day at Auto Restomod. We have the birds singing, we're outside, and incredibly, we're starting off on a brand new truck. Well, not new, this truck is now 10 years old, and therein lies the rub. These trucks, the plastic parts on them, after a couple of years, start to turn gray. They're no longer black like they should be. There are all sorts of things out there to make them black again. There's supposedly some black material that you can put on there that's just a rub-on thing. None of it works. But by the time you go out to a show or whatever with your vehicle, or you just want to drive out on a nice evening out on the town, the stuff has turned gray again and looks like it has since probably the second year you've owned the vehicle. So there are a couple of ways to fix that. One of the ways we've seen is to use a butane torch.
Ooh, my hair.
No. Now, our friend Cam told us about this method. We got kind of excited about it, but we decided to try and go in a little bit different direction, and that's what we're going to show you today. Now, we're going to start off on our 2004 Ford pickup truck, but we're going to end up on our 1969 Fairlane using the same process I'm going to use on this truck on the earlier car, and hopefully be able to make a couple of small repairs on the plastics. We're going to show you how to determine what kind of plastic you have and whether this process is going to work on those parts on your truck or not. So let's get busy by talking about what you need in order to take your wiper arms off of your truck, or indeed any vehicle that you're going to be working with. What we've got here on the hood is a wiper arm removal tool that we got from the guys at National Parts Depot. And what we're going to be doing is taking our wiper arms off for one simple reason, and that is on a chilly day like we've got going on today, yes, even though I'm wearing a short sleeve shirt, you're going to want to be able to get that plastic away from your glass, because if the glass is cold and you go at it with any amount of heat, you could possibly end up wrecking the glass on your truck by getting that heat close to it and heating it when the glass is actually cold. So we're going to take our wiper arms off, pull the plastic trim panel in, take it inside, and see if we can change the color of it. Well, I know we already can, but I'm going to show you just how cool that looks. All right, I'm going to get up in here and take the wiper arm off. There's a little clip on the side of the wiper arm that you need to disengage in order to pull the arm off. You take the removal tool, and you kind of have to do this with two hands, obviously. And you pull the wiper arm off the truck. Now, the clip I'm talking about, this little clip right here. Now, if you don't take this off, you can wreck that. You'll still be able to put the wiper arms back on, but that little safety piece there won't be there. And it'll make you out to be kind of a goober for not having seen that clip and taking it loose. And yes, I have been that goober. Now, we got to get these plastic pieces off the truck, so I've got to open up the hood to do that. Okay, I've got a clip, it's a push clip right here. This needs to come out, and it's basically just a grab clip. So we'll retain that to put that back in there. Now this piece should come right on out. All right, you can see there's some clips at the very back, and what I'm trying to do is drop that back down so I can get these out. I got one clip over here in the back corner that just broke. Now, probably one last thing I need to do is remove this hose from here. Now I can take this in and go in and start working on it. Well, it's nice we have the red-green show today because we have some guy outside using a chainsaw. Now, what I'm going to do here is, these fan panels I feel pretty sure are polypropylene. I've already heated this one just a little bit, you can see it, and just a minute ago I was working on this one as well. But I'm going to show you the process on this. And the thing I notice is that you have to get the gun operating pretty warm before it'll start to make a good pattern, if you will, on the plastic. But this is pretty easy. And I'm a little more fond of it than doing this with the actual butane torch because I like the heating pattern a little bit better. Basically, you'll want to do this almost like you're painting on the car. Like I said, I know that Cam had told us that he had done this with a butane torch. That works okay if you want to try it that way. It's probably a little faster than this. But as you'll see, the heat control on this is just much, much better. Now I can tell that this is polypropylene because it's got kind of a wax smell to it when I heat it. If this were a polyethylene or different kind of plastics, it would have different properties. Polypropylene is one of the best ones to do your heating process with. It'll work the best on this stuff. All right, I'm just about done here. I'm going to finish up this top plate. There's a little bit of detail and stuff that I can still do. There's places where we didn't quite hit it the way we should, but I want to be able to move on and move to our 69 Fairlane so we can talk about it because it uses a real similar plastic, although this one is a little more brittle than what the Fairlane stuff is. But our process that we're using on this will actually apply on that car. So as I finish this up, you can see how much nicer this looks than it used to. We'll move on to our little Fairlane here in just a couple of seconds. Okay, so one of the first things you're going to want to do is to establish what kind of plastic you have. Now, the two best options for doing this kind of thing are polypropylene and polyethylene. How do you know which one you've got? Well, the best thing to do is to do a burn test, which will allow you to play with fire. And we all know how much we like to play with fire. So you'll take this and you'll burn it. If it drips like that, like wax off of a candle and smells like a candle, it's polypropylene. If it smells more accurate with the same kind of drip, it is actually going to be polyethylene. Either one of those two plastics will allow you to do what we're going to be doing here today with our inside trim panel for our early car. So now that we've established that the inside panels on this car will work because we actually pulled that little cut piece off of this old inside kick panel for our 69 Fairlane, we're going to go in and actually do a burn on the panel on one of our older panels to show you what you can do. But I want to hit something else before I do that. And the panel that we're going to be working with, it sits out in the sun and it's starting to do a process that I like to call granola-ing. And basically, it's just turning into small chunks of plastic, which is what we're going to show you in a minute, how to get rid of it doing that. But if you have places on there that you want to try to put the graining back in, it's going to be very, very difficult. I haven't had a whole lot of success at it, but I'm going to show you the process that I went through to get to being able to actually grain the parts. Now, the first thing I grabbed was this. This is some stuff that we got from the hobby store, and it's basically brass that is 0.05 thick. And while it sounds really cool, it's absolutely useless for making grain. The next thing I thought about using was some tin foil. And like the brass piece, it's just inappropriate for making grain. It will make the grain, but it's so thin that it won't hold the grain if you start putting any kind of pressure on it. The next thing I tried was using steel wool on the stuff, and actually this is stainless steel wool. It didn't work. The next thing I tried to use was a MyGrip. Now you can get this at hardware stores across the United States. And what you do is I went in and actually heated this up and pressured it into the polypropylene kick panel, and it made a little bit of grain, but not much, so that didn't work either. Okay, now I'm going to show you a method for hopefully putting the vinyl graining back in here that's a little unorthodox. What I've got here underneath our panel is the vinyl repair kit from the guys at Eastwood. Now we are going to use one of the cards out of here to regrain our plastic. But what we're also going to do down the road is we're going to try to use this kit to repair the seat in our 69 Fairlane. The front seat has a hole in it from probably something being put in the back of the wagon, and it's sliding forward and knocking the center out of the back of the seat. So it's got a nice rip. We're going to go and repair it with this. Now, another product that Eastwood has come out with is this one. It's called Plastic Resurfacer. This is good for bumpers and things like that. Like we showed you a little earlier with the heat process, this is actually a chemical process to do pretty much the same thing. We're also going to show you how this works on our trim panel as well. We're going to do a little bit of a test out with it and see how we like it. From what I understand, this stuff actually works pretty good on your newer cars for those areas that we've gone in and done the heat process with. This is just a way to do it chemically rather than using a heat gun. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pull all this stuff out of the way, and I'm going to go in and show you how to use the graining cards to hopefully get some grain back in some of these places where you've got chunks taken out of the plastic on your trim pieces inside your car. If you're going to do what I'm starting to do here, I absolutely recommend you get the vinyl repair kit from Eastwood because of these graining cards. It's going to make your job a lot easier. You're not ever going to be able to pull the grain out of anything else that I've been able to come up with to make this work. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to put a glove on because this is going to be very hot work. That paper is going to transfer all the heat through it once I get these areas hot. What you'll want to do is, you'll see I've got an area here that is really glossy. You're going to want to heat that area up till it gets wet looking, like that. Then lay the card on it, rub around on it a little bit, and pull it back. It grains some, but we're going to go in and try to hit it a little harder. Now, sometimes what can happen when you're trying to do this graining work is you can pick up the old vinyl, and that comes from the fact that that upper surface is really pretty loose. But you can see the center section of this right in here, it's actually put a grain in there, and it's pretty close to looking like the original. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go in and continue to work this area using my card, but I'm going to get these chips that are on here off the card, because if you don't, they'll just put a different impression in there and you'll have an odd looking spot in your vinyl. This is only going to be good for cleaning up small areas too. You're not going to want to try to regrain an entire panel with this because it's just not going to work. It's looking like what you probably will want to do is to leave it on there and let it cool in position and then pull it up. And I think in some cases with the polypropylene plastic being the way it is, it's still going to pull that upper layer off. So I'm going to keep working this, and then I'm going to show you how this product, the plastic resurfacer, works. And we'll kind of close it out with that one. Okay, here's the trim panel after we've used the plastic resurfacer from Eastwood on it. I will say that it does a really nice job of solidifying the plastic and making it where it won't granola. It's really not going to be good for, and it's not intended to, fill in any places where the plastic is scratched off. That's just not going to happen. So it might be a better idea to go in and use the heat gun to take these areas like we've done on here and heat them and reset the plastic, as it were, and put a little bit of grain in them, because otherwise I think it's probably going to be pretty noticeable, especially in lighter color plastics, that you've got this done. But as I said, this product is really good for taking this plastic and solidifying it so it won't granola up in your finger whenever you go to put it back in the car. And I also actually kind of like the color. It's a little duller than some of the other stuff. It looks a little more like the original plastics on the cars. So I like this product, and I also like being able to use the little pieces of paper like this that we got with the vinyl repair kit. So that's our show for this week, folks. Now come back and watch us next time on Auto Resto Mod. Have a great week, folks.
my chest.